And welcome to another Pike and Shot battle. This is Lützen, 1632. I am commanding Gustavus Adolphus's Swedish army. Also wanted to start with a quick book recommendation. Peter Wilson wrote the current best English language book on the Thirty Years' War, called The Thirty Years' War. He also wrote a book called Lützen about both the battle itself and the battle in cultural memory. It's a good read, and I learned a lot that I didn't know about it before, so recommend it. I'll put a link below. In the meantime, we can choose some additions to our army if we want more infantry or more cavalry. And I want more infantry. Command and shot and light guns or cavalry? A little bit more cavalry. Not sure of how familiar you are with the battle, but basically attacking through the town of Lützen and the castle will be a nightmare. There will be artillery placed on the windmill hill and infantry deployed behind commanded shot holding these light field fortifications. Later in the battle, imperialist reinforcements starting with cavalry and followed by infantry under Pappenheim will appear here. So it's up to the Swedes to attack and get the job done. Okay, so the victory conditions are slightly different from usual. It's 24 instead of 25%, which is a little bit easier. And we win if we inflict 54% losses, which is also easier. Visibility is low because there's a lot of fog. So, here we are. Start lining up the salvo foot for a head-on push. Our guns aren't going to be much use. It's hard to see, and there's no high ground to put them on. Try to form up something of a battle line before advancing. We also don't want to wait too long though, because imperialist reinforcements are on the way. Send our commanded shot into these woods and stream. And just send them a little bit ahead to scout things out. Get some horse to push this wing as well. They're not good for much else in this scenario. Okay, next turn. I assume he's just redeploying his defenses and not pushing out. Okay. Medium guns, what would their field of fire be? Well, right, then I'll have to pace it out. That's plenty for range. Now we just need to see them. Alright, so we'll finish getting our cavalry fully on the wings with infantry and some infantry reserves, and then we'll attack. Simple. Next turn. All right, he's scouting things out too. Good. Okay, I think in maybe a turn or two we should be ready for a wholesale advance. Next turn. Alright, we formed a solid enough line. Next turn it can move forward. Shift our commanded shot down to support the cavalry wing. Very good. Commanded Shot will attempt to seize the town of Lutzen. It's not going to happen, but they might as well at least mask its fortifications. Next turn. Oh, hello. Oh, interesting. Going for the flank, I guess, but we should be able to prevent that easily enough. Okay. The shot will count as commanded with the horse being adjacent like that. Great. Don't really know what I'm going to do with this wing, running into this town and walls, but there's nowhere else to go, so. So, just like the real battle of Lutzen, we'll pretty much hurl ourselves forward in unimaginative frontal assault. Okay, there we are. Next turn. Think these windmills are actually still there at the Lutzen battlefield. They might be reconstructions, actually, I'm not sure. Let's just shove them off a bit. And the commanded shot will scout ahead. Yeah, of course. Pike and Shot are armored, which they generally are not in skirmish modes. Up to 17 POA. However, fighting, say, an unarmored Pike and Shot unit would only be like 6 or 7 POA, because in the combat against the Musketeers, I think it's two-thirds reduced if the unit is two-thirds muskets. Could be wrong about that, though. That'll be something interesting to check on once things are truly underway. I mean, not that that really matters that much. I could leave this gap for my guns, but I'd rather just clean up the line, honestly. Here's the current situation. Next turn. All right. Still can't see his main force. Kind of alarms me a little bit. Push on then. There we go. It's a formidable position. Taking some pot shots, nothing important. Guess now we can. Well, that's what we can do. All right. Next turn. So normally that would work, but our command shot are adjacent to friendly cavalry, so they get protected status. So they took losses and bounced. And we let one through, so they'll take out our guns, but I don't think it's worth the effort of turning these units around to try to prevent anything happening. So the hell with it. That's what we get for opening up our line like that. I wonder if this whole area is lined with musketeers. It probably is. Maybe we can slip one through. I don't know if this cavalry will accomplish anything, but it's either that or sitting there doing nothing, so. So these are medium fortifications. They offer 2/3 cover, so shooting is going to be pretty much completely ineffective. I mean, we'll open fire anyway, but give them a shove and break them, pursue ahead and see what you can see. Nothing yet, too bad. Getting a little bit reckless, but we'll just say that we're role-playing. Very good. Next turn. Rush ahead and, oh, hello. Right. Not much to do but to push forward. I'm hoping to break these guns so I can get up here and charge past the fortifications. There's so little to see. There they are. Oh no, that's unfortunate. It's fine to absorb some fire for the infantry. Worth a try. Here, you try now. Good, they stuck, so should help. They're protected because they're behind this low stone wall. But they don't get a melee POA, so we're still gonna win. Probably. Need to get our cavalry into contact as rapidly as possible here, but I think they're gonna cave. But that's kind of okay. What we need to do is kind of work up the sides of this windmill hill and charge in and nibble at the edges. Pretty tough. But It's not like there's a lot of subtle stuff you can do with the battlefield this constricted. Next turn. Good. Maybe, depending on which way we go. Could be... Oh no, that's fine. That's terrible. They'll rout. Commanded shot, so plus 100 POA on impact, plus 50 for the light guns, so we had 150. Possible silver lining, if these units pursue this way, maybe we can catch them in the flank. Maybe. Or it's wishful thinking. Well, this is working out historically. All right. I wonder. Nope. Worth a try. Well, in that case, we're gonna have to draw some fire with the cavalry. Drew a little bit, not as much as I would like. Good. Draw some fire. No. Too disciplined. Very good. Uh-huh. Ah, such a waste of good infantry. Probably need replacements over here when things go bad. I was hoping for a better impact there, and we got heavy fortifications, so even though they're disrupted, we can't really touch them. That will be the old city walls and castle, I suppose. These medieval fortifications were pretty effective, even in the 17th century. I think during the English Civil War, the old castles held up pretty well, too. Here, absorb some bullets to let the veterans in. Well, that was almost a good impact. Who has not fired? You have not fired. No dice. Okay. This could get ugly, but I think we're gonna have to accept some horrific close-range volleys in order to get the salvo foot into charge range, because they are salvo, plus 200 versus any foot. Pretty ridiculous. Unless we disrupt, then it's not that useful. Right, this whole situation is quite odd. Disruption, good. Can't decide if I want to fire or charge. Shove them. Oh. Okay. Well, in that case. Veteran horse, hackpels. Back. We'll take a bit of a risk here. We have impact mounted, and the cuirassiers are a superior horse. A superior determined horse can fight on even impact, but a superior horse cannot. But we did not disrupt them, so things will go badly with our lightly armored fins. I mean, this is going okay. Depends how badly our cavalry fares against well-armored Imperial cavalry, and also how many disruptions we suffer here before we can get into impact with our salvo foot. Okay, I think this will be the key turn. Not really worried about the flank too much, I'm more concerned about this center action. Huckabell's failed us again. Firm there and there so far. Nope. Pass the extra cohesion check from artillery. Good. Overall, this is not too bad. Looks like we'll lose both cavalry wings, so. Okay. Let's get in the way and give our cavalry time to rally. You must do the same. Very good. See where that leads our horsemen. Oh, that's just not helpful at all. Get in now, instead, or get shot at. Hopefully they rally up in the melee. Okay. Held firm. Held firm. There we go. Take some fire. Charge. Disruption. It's not good enough. Working on them. If we can frag and break them and gain the crest, that would be very nice. Well, that's... yeah. Okay, guys. Lovely. Suppose you must pile in. So how's this going? Not great, I'd say. This is the only part that's going well, but I don't know if on its own it's going to be enough to exploit the situation. Next turn! That is not what I wanted at all. Fragged them. Shaping up to be a disaster, I think. Which is not ahistorical. That could help a bit. Depending on which way we go. reinforcements are on their way then. We're through, for whatever that's worth. Good. Charge so you can stop getting shot at. Take a risk. That's why it was a risk. Good. How bad? Bad, but what else are we gonna do? Turn. Charge. We're moderately disordered because we're crossing medium fortifications, but they're disrupted, so we should be able to grind them down. Very well. Go for impact again. Nope. Failure again. Held firm. these units break and he pursues, then we can catch him in the flank. Looking bad, though. Just mismanaged our cavalry. Too aggressive, although it is a narrow battlefield. Next turn. Very nice. I mean, you know, not for me, obviously. Set up a chain reaction. Yep, there's gonna be an overcharge into this unit. Yeah, we committed the left wing far too soon. Felt necessary at the time, but clearly was a mistake. Can hold for a turn. Oh no, the light guns do exert his own control. And the reinforcements are here. We need to inflict 35% losses to get a technical win, and I don't think we're going to get a technical win. A double dropped there. Maybe. Nope, not quite. Well, we can at least kill some lights. And get a flank attack thanks to that pursuit. And occupy these fortifications, which will protect us from fire from here. I'm not sure about here. I think it actually might, but not really certain about that. Hopefully they don't pursue into my open flank there. Did make a minor mistake here, leaving this flank uncovered. Absorb some fire. Thank you. Well, the best we can do is move to where we are disordered and a zone of control lock this unit. I wonder why he doesn't just charge these guns. Maybe there's some reason that he can't. Passed another cohesion check. That's it. Barry Graham. Both flanks looking quite bad, especially the left, though. Center's not looking great either. Next turn. Well, maybe we'll catch them. Any fails? No. It does open a flank up potential. Oh. Guess I should have expected that. They are veterans. Well, historically, the Swedes at least held the field by the end of the day. I don't believe that's going to be the case here. Thank you. Of course. There they go. Right, this is going well. Oh, interesting. So I don't think these commanded shot exert a zone of control unless they are in protected status by friendly cavalry, which these are not. So with that in mind, if they break, we might be able to flank attack by pursuit into there. So I will not charge because that could mess it up. Might as well go for the flank. Auto breaks. Do we continue? Perhaps not. Keep charging, see what happens. That's not what I had in mind. You too, then. No luck. Not for you, anyway. Well, that dooms the center. Can only hope to continue, yep, and perhaps right into the next unit. No. Oh man. as well get out of there. Here's for impact. No. They've been terribly disappointing. What a disaster. Goodbye to the center this turn, I think. Next turn. Well, we're close to a tactical victory. We need one more percent, and of course for him not to rally up. Hoping they would pursue a little further. Oh, good. There's a flank attack. Excellent. Get out of there. Held firm, too bad. They pursue. Oh. Well, they're disrupted, so they're not going to fare very well. It's too bad we don't have more cavalry here. And he's still at 34, that's unfortunate. That's not going to do you very much good. So we're zone of control locked by this unit, but if we move here, we're freed up to charge in the flank. Although they still hold, unfortunately. Although this is tempting, we're not going to do it. Damn. That maneuver did pay off. Oh no! If I could have kept them in the field, I could have flanked these units, but it was not to be. Well, zone of control lock this unit to protect the flank. And in the meantime, charge. Might as well join in at this point. Surprised they held firm for that. This unit will wait until they turn around, I think. Well, maybe we'd be better off going for that impact. What a mess. Might get the technical win next turn, though. I really, at this point, I mean, I'm gonna lose the battle, whether I get the technical win or not. I just want to take this damned hill. It's caused so much suffering. Next turn. Going to be close to 60 by the end of this turn. Too bad they caught us. Oh. What a shame. That's so annoying. Finally getting to charge range of this damned hill and disrupt right away. Well, at least we got the technical win for 40%. That could help things. Well, we briefly held one of the three fortifications. I'm surprised they held out. Okay. Is that worth it, or should we turn to flank this unit? Or we could hit these commanded shot, but I think I would prefer all in all. Well, we'll compromise. There, now we have options. No choice, unfortunately. Not much is even left to move. That's it. Hopefully we hold on to this 40% if he doesn't rally. Next turn. Rally to disrupt it, I believe. Actually good. I think I'd rather get meleeed than shot at. Really was a mistake to try to assault this hill. I should have just tried to go around, as difficult as that would have been. Very unfortunate, this frag unit is still holding out. Maybe now's the time. Oh, we're reaching 60, too bad. Seems it'll end before we can take out these two units. Here we go. zoom out, because of course we don't have the post-battle view of FOG2. Right, so we have the technical victory. I think I tried to play this maybe a little too historically accurately. I should have, instead of assaulting the Windmill Hill, any infantry I sent that direction, I really should have funneled to the left to try to fight my way through here and have my cavalry follow. I don't think I made too many drastic mistakes on the right. I got pretty unlucky with my Hakkapels. They never really did much head-on, which was a shame. And I kind of scrambled my deployment a little bit for the infantry assault here. But again, the salvo foot really just kind of depends on dice rolls, which of course is not a good thing to depend on. And if you don't have overwhelming victory across the board, you just kind of get messed up. I did sort of make a mistake and allow his cavalry to kind of foul up my charges as well. Overall, though, I'm not entirely displeased. It's a tough scenario as the Swedes, especially when you play it historically. I've played this scenario before as the Imperialist, where the Swedish player just kind of hangs out on their side of the map until I got bored and attacked. Hitting all these fortifications and this hill and the town of Lützen with the citadel is a tough task. And I'll take 45%. And of course, this is basically what happened historically. The Swedish army held the field at the end of the battle, to be fair, because the Imperialists lost their nerve and withdrew. But the Swedish army had effectively been destroyed as well, especially its veteran infantry regiments. So, good game to my opponent. And till next time.